So we've made it to the end of Iron Street here in Upper Michigan today. We're in front of the cone on Iron Street.
Well, I think we should turn this into a little competition. It's beautiful outside. I see some cornhole happening. I say first one who gets it in gets to try the ice cream. All right, so we're both...
Okay, but isn't ice cream meant for sharing, like, one scoop for two? Isn't that, like, a thing? A milkshake, two straws? No?
Yes!
No! Okay, well, fine. I'll pick these up. We'll head inside. So here's just one example of how the city of Negaunee is making... the whole city, the whole downtown area is inviting for people.
Yeah, this is awesome.
Stop and play. Slow down a little bit. Mm-hmm. So we're here at the cone on Iron Street. We have the owner, Amanda DeGrave, joining us. Thank you so much for having us. How have things been going so far this summer with your ice cream shop open?
Things have been going really good. And honestly, I thought that was going to take a lot more time to
I played a little bit of cornhole.
Okay, nice job. You get some ice cream.
Thank you.
No, things have been really good, actually. The community has given us a really warm welcome here, and the city of Negaunee has made it really easy to be here.
I mean, I bet this is just an incredible addition, especially during Pioneer Days, after all of the softball action at Lacombe Field, to have an ice cream treat to cool off with, and then with all of the summer Little League games going on. And I also just want to point out how cute the shop is. It's got this classic ice cream parlor vibe mixed with modern. It looks really, really nice in here.
Thank you. Yeah, this is, it's been a labor of love. But you're right, the city kind of needed their ice cream shop back.
Yeah, they did. And what do you have on the menu? What are you offering to the city of Negaunee in this? Because this used to be an ice cream shop, so you're taking this place of this historic shop, and you're...
It used to be Buster's, which everybody loved and missed a lot. Closed before COVID and then never reopened. But so at the Cone, we kind of pride ourselves on really good ice cream. It's from Cedar Crest, which is out of Wisconsin. So starting with that, that's an easy sell. And then we have a lot of really fun toppings. And I guess I would call what we do ice cream art.
Thing that catches my eyes the most are these dogs over here.
Okay, and so all of those dogs have visited the shop.
That's so cool.
And I just have to plug, these are my mom's works.
Oh, that's awesome.
She does pet portraits.
That's super cool, and they're the best boys. I see them enjoying the ice cream.
Yeah. Is ice cream art art with ice cream or art of ice cream? Is that something you could show us?
Yes, I've really.
This one's awesome.
Okay. Okay, what's this I see about a boozy milkshake? You don't have to make one of those for us, but that's something that seems unique to an ice cream shop.
We also really like to collaborate with the folks in Negaunee. So across the street at Bars Bar, you can go ahead and get the base of your boozy cocktail, bring it over here, and we'll make it a milkshake.
That's so cool.
And now we can only do that when there are adults working in the shop, so it isn't all the time. But there'll be a sign up over there, there'll be a sign up over here.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
We also do these amazing ice cream sandwiches with collaboration with Midtown Bakery. So they make the cookies, and then we put the ice cream inside.
Awesome. I love to see how all these businesses are collaborating together, too.
And I did just get myself an ice cream bike from Love & Bicycles.
That's cool.
So pretty soon we'll be pedaling.
Well, it's nice to hear like the collaboration with everyone, and I'm really excited to learn more about that, because it's like everyone kind of helps everybody. It's cool to see.
That's the ice cream bar, but I don't want to bypass the ice cream truck because the ice cream bicycle. Because ice cream trucks have become obsolete, and I yearn for that nostalgic sound of the ice cream man. Yeah. Your bike's got to have the sound, though.
We will have it.
That is perfect to hear. Look at this unicorn.
So this is a unicorn sundae, and it has been in the freezer for a minute, so it doesn't look absolutely perfect. But we have a lot of toppings here, which the kids love. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, ice cream is good, but then you put nerd clusters on top, and gummy worms.
And you just take it to the next level.
These sort of, like, gourmet sprinkles. We have edible glitter. This is edible.
Wow.
It's on here.
It really is almost like art. I mean, with everything that you can incorporate into it.
We have edible butterflies.
What?
And it's always changing.
Well, this certainly seems unique. I haven't been to an ice cream shop that does it like this. So you open up at 2 o'clock, you're closed at 9, correct. So you get some nice ice cream treats in the afternoon. We're running out of... Oh, that's so fun. We're running out of time here, okay. So if you want to see...
Yeah, we open at 2. The only day we're closed is Tuesdays. Our menu is always changing. We just got a hot dog machine, so we'll be... That's just recently added to our menu, and we're just evolving to see what the community needs.
So again, it sounds like some future developments. You'll just have to stay tuned for what the cone has in store for the future.
I'm excited to see it.
Alrighty, well, we do have to take a commercial break, but we'll wrap all this up when we come back.